In the first part of this video, I'll be installing the 17-tooth sprocket on my Tiger 900. In the second part of the video, Mr. Bill will be installing a 47-tooth sprocket on his Tiger. If you want to see what those, how they affect the Tigers, I'll put a link to that video in the comments section. Okay, I did this sprocket change. I took this 16-tooth sprocket off and put a 17-tooth sprocket on. And I did film that. Although it looks a little dark in the film, so I'm going to kind of show you a little bit. I'm going to do the highlights of the things I didn't think you could see. So here we go. Taking a picture of everything I think you'll need to know, have to do this sprocket swap, and plus maybe a ruler or measuring for you to measure the chain slack. So what you have is you have a torque wrench to torque your sprockets, your rear axle and your front sprocket, a 27 millimeter to take your rear axle bolt off. You're going to need an 8 millimeter socket to take two bolts off in here. You're going to need an 8 millimeter open end to take your shifting linkage off. Gonna need a little 6 millimeter here to take this off if you want to. You actually can get by without doing that, but I like to do that, take that one off. Of course, you're gonna need a 36 millimeter to take the nut off on the sprocket. You're gonna need a couple of maybe chisels or screwdrivers to pry the lock tab up off the countershaft sprocket. You're going to need a light, and I'll show you what you're going to need that light for a little later on. And this screwdriver here to kind of separate these two things apart. Then I have I use a set of calipers to help me fine-tune the chain adjustment. The marks are actually pretty accurate on there, although I use the calipers to fine-tune that. Mr. Bill doesn't do it like I do. He finds it a little problematic. I've done it enough that I don't have any problem doing that. And I use a soft rubber mallet here to tap things on and off if they get a little sticky. So here we go. You're going to want to pay particular attention to a couple things where they are before you start off with. One would be on a shift assist on your shifter here. I put a little mark here so I can line these back up so it's not too high or not too low. Then also you want to pay a particular attention to how these hoses and wires are routed right here, because there's not a lot of room inside for the countershaft sprocket, and you don't want to get those inside and get those ate up. The first thing I'm going to do is take this 8 millimeter bolt out. You may be able to gently move this off. Yes. You may not. Yes. You can get this off without also taking the 6 millimeter off, but I prefer to do that, to take that one off, because it makes it a lot easier a little bit later on. It gives you a little bit more room to maneuver. And you're just going to have a wire right here. He's going to just pull that down just a little bit. Pull this and just set this out of the way. Now you're going to remove your two 8 millimeter sprocket cover bolts. Doesn't make any difference which one you remove first, although when you put them back on, I think you'll find that if you put the bottom one on first, it makes it a little easier. Oh, well, you're always so close, and the knees grow weak. before I even started this, because I use, you can do this with the bike on the ground, so the rear wheel doesn't move when you're trying to remove the large nut on the 36 millimeter nut on the countershaft sprocket, or if you get it up in the air like I do, I'll put it into gear. So it would be into gear. Then you're going to have to kind of wiggle this out. Now you see how you can see how close these things are here. So you want to make sure you get those out of the way. All right. What you do, you'll leave it in gear and leave the chain with tension on it still yet. Then what you're going to use is going to use your chisels, or you can use a little screwdriver and put these up and just hit it with the hammer here in order to get this tab where it's straight up. This is a locking tab. That locking tab off, up. And once you get the locking tab up, then you can use your 36 millimeter to remove this. Okay, this is put on with about 85 newton meters of torque, about 63 foot pounds of torque. So you loosen that up. So you have to wiggle it out. But in order to wiggle this out, what you're gonna need to do first is, because two things. If you're going from a 16 to a 17, that sprocket's bigger, so you're gonna need more room. So what you wanna make sure you do, and even if you would go down from a 17 to 16, you still need some slack in your chain. So the thing is then to do would be to use your 27, number 27 wrench on your, loosen up your axle bolt, loosen up, use your 12 and 13s to loosen up the little adjusters on your chain. Push the wheel forward so you have a lot of slack in the chain. Then that lets you, you're able to wiggle this off. Then once you wiggle it off, the only hard part of this comes next. Your new sprocket, in this case it was a 17 tooth, into the chain. You'll find that there's not enough slack in here to put the sprocket on first, then thread the chain around it. Sprocket into the chain, I'm sorry. And then you'll put this back on. Now here's where the light comes in. Because on these have to fit over the shaft, the drive shaft. And in order to fit over that shaft, all these little male and female ends have to line up. It's very, very difficult to do that when you're working with and trying to wiggle this chain on. But I found that the best thing to do, and it really does help you a lot, get you some sort of light like I have here, and thread this light so it's showing, it's backlighting the sprocket, and that will show you the shaft and how to align this. This will save you probably 15 minutes if you use a little backlight. You can get down there, and when you're putting on, you can see where it fits. Then it'll just slide right on. But if you don't, it's just, do you get lucky in 5 minutes, or you get lucky in 15 minutes, or you get lucky in 30 minutes? This is the longest thing, will take you the longest, and it's the hardest part. Okay, now that you got the sprocket back on, you put your little tab washer on, and it has a little feed that goes around it too. So it has little teeth in here too, so you'll put that on and make sure that it's the concave is facing out towards you. Once you get the countershaft nut on there, what you'll need to do is pull back the rear wheel and remove the slack you have in the chain. You'll adjust your chain adjusters up a little bit. You'll tighten up and snug up the rear axle just a little bit
so you can torque down that countershaft sprocket to 85 newton meters or 63 foot-pounds.
So once you get this back on, you want to bend this tab back down, and you can go back kind of the reverse process here. You just kind of put this in here and knock it down. You want to get it so it's at least on one of the here, one of the flats here, majority of that. You might want to take a rag and wipe off the grease that you have in here beforehand. Now remember, I told you, you got to make sure you get these into this slot here. If you can, put those wires and hoses in there, in the slot, and then you can wiggle this on a little bit better. Now this goes into the in here also. So you get to make sure you got all your wires and your hoses in this. I recommend putting in the bottom one first because it's a little harder to line up. Now that you get that on, you want to put your shifter back on. Okay. So we'll put the wire back in. Goes right underneath there. And then we'll line up our lines that we had before. One or two teeth here make the difference in whether that's too high or too low for you. You want to start it down here. And you get your 8mm. Get that start back again. You'll be able to turn it just to where you can see the threads. And you finish it off with your 8mm. Don't forget to tighten up your six here. If you just got it on there barely. We'll test it. We could do it a little bit like this. We'll test it and make sure it works all right once we get the chain adjusted. Mount, what I like to do is find the chain and go around and see if there's any tight spots in the chain. Most of the new chains really don't get a lot of tight spots. Not like the old chains used to do. So if you don't find a tight spot, just find someplace like right here. I know that's where I'm gonna check it. So I want to get my chain adjustment. It has it in your book. I think on the GTs and GT Pros it's 0.98 to 1-point-something inches of travel here, which is about 25 to 35 millimeters. And I'm not gonna do that to make the adjustments. I'll make my adjustments using the little indentions on the chain. I'll get that close, then that's when I'll go to the micrometer and dial it in just a little bit closer. So if it looks like it's a little bit on the loose side, it will tighten up once you put the bike back on the ground and you're set on the bike. And that's basically it. I think it's a lot easier to do this than doing the rear sprocket. So we'll start it up and make sure it shifts okay. Okay, it seems like it got it back in the right spot and it shifts all right. And at this point, I've got my chain adjusted like I want it to be adjusted. The rear axle nut is 110 newton meters, 81 foot pounds. So that one is 81 foot pounds, 110 newton meters. This one is 85 newton meters, or 62 or 63 foot pounds of torque. So get those dial in just like you want them, and there you, Bob's your uncle.
we got it nice and flush in here. We'll adjust these later. Right now we're going for the preliminary, getting the axle in and properly set.
You notice how big that wrench that Mr. Bill has there. He's kind of snugging that up, axle up a little bit, and he's gonna loosen it up after he gets that before he does the chain adjusters. And he's using the dots here primarily. I use the dots also, but also go to the micrometer just to dial it in a little closer. But those dots are really, really right on target, so you won't have any problems using that. In this video, we gave you the official torque specs from Triumph. However, Mr. Bill and I sometimes use a little bit different torque spec, especially for the rear axle. We find that if you're out on the road and you don't have one of those big wrenches, you cannot possibly undo 110 newton meters with some of the wrenches we carry. Hopefully the folks that asked to see this video will find it useful to them. I know it's a bit long, but I don't think there's anything in here that I'd like to take out. So thanks for watching.
Join me and my friends at Flat Cap Cafe Racer for riding and racing. Please subscribe.